They're very stressed out.
Accuse the government of robbing people of hope. I spoke to him earlier and began by asking why he's so furious.
We were told that the vaccines were the way out of this. We were told when Christmas was cancelled, celebrate your Christmas and Easter. Bring your family together then because the vaccines will allow that. And a lot of people have been holding on through the long winter months, looking forward to that date in Easter. And what the Secretary of Transport has done by telling people not even to plan their domestic summer days is to suggest unwittingly, or wittingly, I don't know, that perhaps lockdown is going to extend from the spring into the summer and beyond. And that is a terribly irresponsible thing to do, a terribly, terribly irresponsible thing to do with a very stressed out nation.
I mean, could it be that actually the irresponsible thing to do was to tell people that things were going to be okay?
We've got a vaccine with a very stressed out nation. We've got a vaccine with high efficacy. There will always be new variants of coronavirus. That's what coronaviruses do. They evolve, and this will happen year after year after year. The current situation is absolutely not sustainable. It's not sustainable for people's mental health and emotional well-being. It's not sustainable for business. It is not sustainable in any way at all. Now, I hope that Grant Shapps was speaking out of turn. I hope it was a mistake. I hope the Prime Minister reins him in. The government is running a deliberate programme to scare people witless. So you've got people who are now frightened to leave their homes in case they get this virus. That, by the way, most people recover from. And with a vaccine, will be far less severe than it is now for many people.
So are you saying we need to learn to live with a certain amount of death through coronavirus? That's a hard thing for you to tell Grant Shapps today, isn't it, when his dad is in hospital?
My father died at 46. Didn't expect the world to stop for me. I was very sad. The world went on. If we're going to start citing our own personal situations as a reason for doing something or not, we're getting into very dangerous territory. This isn't about what happened to me. It's not about what's happening to everybody in the cabinet. It's about the fact that millions and millions of our constituents are under an enormous amount of stress. And what we've done now, today, is perhaps rob them of that hope that was keeping them going. I'm really sorry, but I'm not getting into this game where somehow a death from coronavirus is different from a death from cancer or a death from heart disease. We accept that 20,000 people die from flu every year. We accept that 617,000 people die every year from old age. But somehow, you're not allowed to die from coronavirus ever. We cannot cancel life to preserve every life.